Hi everyone. Today we are going to learn chmod command. So my previous video I have showed you how to use chmod command, including users and group files, how to use the user and group files, how to edit that group file. So if you yet didn't see the chmod command video, then you first see the video, then it would be good for you to learn about chown command. Today we are going to learn only 6 chown command that we are generally used in Linux distribution. So if you know that 6 different type of command, chown command, then you will learn everything about chown command. So let's get started. Okay, so this is my file, this is my my sound is not good, that's why I have to hold this microphone with me, that's why my typing is very slow. So we are going to work on the tt folder. Okay, ls -ltr. So that's root command. So first of all, how to change the only the owner or user permission. Okay, how only we gonna change it? This is only root and root, the user and group. So we are only change the user part. Okay, how can we change that? Next one is how we can only change the group portion. Okay, the group part. If you want to change both user and group with same user and group, then how can you change? It's a very small command. First of all, you see both are change. When you need all user and group same person or same name, then you only type the first part, so you can change everything. Okay, the group and user automatically the same. So the next one is how can you change user and group to different name. So okay, Ali operations. You see, I have already created a user named Ali and operations group already exists. How can you check that? I have already shown you on my previous video. You can check it out if you don't understand. You can see here operations group I have created before. Operations group, this Ali group. Okay, so Ali user is also created there. That's fourth portion. Now the another thing is we can check LD current directory permission root. If you want to change, directory means folder permission is root. Inside tt ltr we have different permission of different users and groups. So you want to change these things, this permission as well as the inner files also. So all the permissions in that folder will be the same. So how can you do that? Okay, so cd this R means recursive. Okay, so you see tt is changed, and inside tt what's the status? See, everything is mhsn. So all the files inside the directory will be mhsn. If you use minus r parameter, okay. So group name is wrong. Okay. You want to change this permission to here from there. So this is the different type of chown command. This is generally we do not use in Linux distribution. Really, if you want to use, you can use, but it's really don't very much used in Linux distribution. So I can show you. See, it's changed. This permission is gone to there. So this file now has the same permission from Ali to operations to mhsn. This is the current owner, current group changed to new owner, new group. Okay, that's all. The final chown command is little bit interesting. I can show you first, then I can discuss about that. So now the file permission is same, both are same. So first I change one of this file permission. So now what I'm going to do is this Ali operation file, Ali operation permission on this file is changed to there by referencing this file. Okay, whatever this file has the permission will be changed to the text222.txt file. So how can you do that? Permission that has on the FLB file will be transferred to the test file. Okay, only the permission. Okay, now check that out. You see that this permission will go to, is gone to the test file. Okay, you see Ali operations, this full permissions is gone to the test222 file. Okay, that's it guys. I will give you some details on that on my description. If you like this video, please subscribe and like.